In this empty space, phantom particles appear and disappear. For their existence, they transfer energy from one place to another. In front of the black holes, virtual matter and antimatter is separated by event horizon, which emits the Hawking radiation later. To clearly understand these, watch the video till end. First, we know about origin of virtual particles. Whenever we see any empty space or a black spot in this universe, we feel that there is nothing in existence there. But actually, there is something. There are different types of fields like electromagnetic field, Higgs field, etc., who constantly exchange energies among themselves. But how do they do it? Let us understand this by an example. Let us assume that there are two electrons that are in excited states. If we take these electrons close to each other, then they will repel each other through electromagnetic field. In this, each electron give light mild shocks to the electromagnetic field, due to which the shocks reappear to the other electron, and after which it again shakes the electromagnetic field, so that the cycle continuous goes on. But how often does this cycle occur? How do we find out? For this, we have to get the help of perturbation theory. In this, we first mathematically add different interactions and some later interactions which gives us virtual particle. Let's understand this with our electron example. We can see that whenever the electron is interacting with the electromagnetic field, it is transferring energy, momentum and single packet of photon, which we call a virtual photon. Similarly, these interactions are very often and are different in different fields, and each interaction it transfers a particle, virtual particle. These state of interaction are called intermediate state or virtual state. But in reality, such states does not exist and virtual particles never exist individually. But how can we say that? For this, we have a theory of Feynman diagram. Richard Feynman made a diagram in which he told that which intermediate state we can consider during the interaction of a particle and which can be ignored. Whatever particle enter in this diagram and leave it, they are real particle. But those particles that begin in the same diagram and finishes within the diagram, we call it a virtual particle. We think that virtual particles travel only in space, and not only that, but they do have some properties, even if they are different from real particles. Like they can have any value of mass, it can travel with the speed of light or even faster, and it can also go back in time. This happens to them because they do not physically exist. In the first example, we saw that electrons were repelling each other by transferring virtual photon between them. But what would happen if there were attractive forces between them? Meaning, if there is an electron and the other positron, then how can it come closer to each other by transferring virtual photon between them? Let's understand it from a diagram in which the electron is sending one single photon into positron. We will have to consider every single virtual photon that emit the electron and is absorbing positron and vice versa. Some photons that are coming from positron are not able to go into the electron and cross it. And some virtual photon is not moving in the direction of electron and going in its opposite direction, due to which attractive force is being generated between them. But how are these photons journeying between these particles? Actually, they are not traveling anymore. These virtual particles exist everywhere for trillionth of a second, which store quantum energies in itself, which releases energy on each and every vibration in the quantum field. You must have heard that many particle and antiparticle came into existence in each and every second, which are called vacuum fluctuation or zero point energy. I have already made a video on it. If you want to watch it, then click on the icon. It does not happen with the virtual particle that they came into existence and go again. But what if someone interact with them? This will give us Hawking radiation, in which Stephen Hawking first took the help of virtual particles to explain his theory, in which he had said that the event horizon of a black hole separates the antiparticle and the virtual particle, so that the particle moves in some different reality and which left behind the radiation, and afterward it results in the shrinking of a black hole. So let us take a quick recap of what we have understood in this video. Virtual particle is not like a real particle. Their properties are different from real particle, like their mass may vary. That means sometimes it fluctuates to very high and sometimes it very low. But if it is a fixed, then it will behave like a real particle. It can move back and forth in time. That means it can travel in time. But real particles cannot travel in time. In the space, virtual particles work as energy carriers, which can transport energy from one field to another. It can also be a means of exchange energy with some matter and antimatter, and if it interact with any other particles, then emit radiation. And in the end, it also explains the most important topics like gravitational wave, zero point energy and Casimir effect. So guys, that's all for today's topic. If you learned something new, then please subscribe to my channel and like this video. I need your support to grow my channel. At last, thank you.